So if I could go back 20 years and spend 10 or 15 minutes talking with myself, giving myself the tips that I need to improve, I'm pretty sure 10 or 20 minutes, I could save a few years off my photography and overcoming some frustration and roadblocks and self-improvement. So let's get into this. There's a lot of different techniques, tips given to individuals looking for help in their photography. And that's one of the situations where you have to be careful, because a lot of people, well, you need to know artificial light, you need to know natural light, you need to go black and white, you need to go film, you need one lens, you need one focal length, all this stuff. But that really kind of only helps in that one instance. It might help the individual grow, but overall, it's not really what I call a key to photography. So if I could go back 10, 20 years, I wouldn't necessarily mention any techniques or tips. I would mention keys. Again, they're much more powerful, they're much more abstract, but in the right hands, with the right frame of mind, you're gonna progress a lot quicker, because individuals go to other individuals to ask for advice and they get little tips, tricks, and it kind of becomes wasteful and it's not necessarily as helpful as one would think. So, here's the situation. 1 year into my photography, I was had no work to show put on the wall. I just purchased a house. I wanted to put some nice art on the wall, something I created. It was not going well. Many times I'd go to a photography store. 1 year in, I go to a photography store, pick up some books on lighting and some other things, and next thing, next to me is a woman that's showing off a book, and the people behind the counter are kind of dolting on her. Oh, that's really nice. Oh, this is nice. That's nice. So as things go on, kind of draws your attention. I get pulled into the mix. I'm looking at the photos. I'm like, whoa, these are pretty good. They're pretty substantial. To add injury to insult, this young woman had only been shooting 6 months. And you can imagine how one would feel, right? You're sitting there, wow, okay. So one of the first keys is no one excels or goes at the same rate. Everyone has different roadblocks that come up and spring up. So myself, I didn't really create anything until 2.5 years in. I had nothing to hang on the wall. But putting through a lot of different types of photography, this person was very focused. And so about the second year, I show up and lo and behold, you go to this photography store every 3 to 6 months, the same person's in there on a Saturday, same time. But this time the tone is different. She's walking through her book and the person behind the counter is very, like, not really that happy. I can see a little bit of frustration and the girl's kind of giddy and she's happy flicking through it. And the guy behind the counter, who's a seasoned photographer, says, you know, you need to stop using manual, you need to stop using automatic exposure. You need to use manual exposure, shutter priority, aperture priority, you need to know your meter, you need to know this. And I was kind of taken back. He goes, your photos look all the same. I started thinking about it, and yeah, the photos did really look the same. It was the same angle, same aperture, everything, same kind of lighting. I was like, okay, but more shocking was the fact that she didn't know the exposure triangle. And that takes 6 months, a year, try to know your metering and all that. That takes a while. So for the last 2.5 years, I was doing a lot of photography differently. I was doing flash, studio, portrait, landscape, wildlife, all horribly, by the way, but learning different things. And that's a slower path. It's kind of like the tortoise and the hare. But more so, it wasn't until about 15 years later that I started noticing these patterns in photography. And taking this instance into an example, we were at polar opposites on the way we approach photography. This woman was a person that was given a camera, has a good eye, goes out and just shoots. She doesn't question it. She just put it on automatic exposure and shoot. That being said, this person's shooting, creating a lot of good work, but roadblocks 6 months in. So this individual kind of has to go back to ground or rule one and figure that out. Myself, shooting a whole bunch of different types of photography, horribly, by the way, but things are starting to add up. The experience is getting there. But the other thing is, in the beginning of this video, I asked what type of photographer are you? And it wasn't necessarily to ask you, are you a wildlife, street photographer, portrait? No, it's more along the lines, are you technically minded, like myself, or are you artistically minded, like this woman? Because that's going to tell you a lot more on how to troubleshoot your issues later on down the road. That's going to tell you your personality type. So myself, I could tell you the camera that she had at that day. It was a Rebel camera with like a 50 millimeter lens. Those things kind of stick in your mind. At the time, I could tell you all the different kinds of cameras, the reviews on it, different lighting books, but I really failed at the compositional level. I really failed in artwork and that. This person could probably tell you different types of photography as far as artistic style. That's how they go. So think in your mind, how do you refer to images? What are you spending your time on? If you're looking at sites like DP Review, DxO Labs, Digiloid, all that stuff, that's more technical. If you find yourself looking at paintings, looking at different images and just going through there, how do you resort or how do you look at different photography and image? Same image, a person might say, well, I like the resolution, boy, it's sharp. I wonder how they're doing the exact lighting. Is it technical lighting? Versus, oh, I like the color. I like how it's soft. I like the emotion of the light. This is obviously going to dictate how you study, because your mind's like water. You know, it's going to go to the area that has the least resistance. So if you're a technically minded person, back off on the technical aspects of it. Just, you don't have to worry about as much lighting. That stuff will come a little more natural to you. If you're artistic minded, you're going to have to dig into your camera, obviously. But first, little baby steps. Get a small flash. If you're doing street photography, why not mix a flash in with some street photography? Why not do something else? Obviously, if you're a technical individual, you want to look at compositional books. You want to look at different paintings and lighting and really concentrate on that. And this is a time and time again. Now, it's not always you're going to be this way, but through time, it's generally you'll see people that it's almost as if it's bodybuilding. You work on your upper body, you work on your lower body, and then one part gets larger or better than the rest, built up, then you kind of concentrate on your weak points. But as long as you know where your personality thing, where you're at in your personality, technically minded, artistically minded, things you're good at, the things you suck at, the things that you like, the things that you dislike, you know where to improve. You don't have to ask someone, you know, what's wrong with my photography? Just look at it. What are the things you have done and have not? This is the roadmap to move forward. Parts of your photography where, you know, I don't shoot anything outside of just direct natural light on this lens. We'll get a zoom lens, get a flash. You know, if you're constantly shooting something technical, you're going to have to grab some books. The other thing is, it's a slower process, technical aspect versus the artistic. But the thing is once you get to a certain point, let's say 5 years in, and you understand a lot of the lighting, you can start mimicking some really good photography. You can, oh, okay, I kind of know where he put the lights. I'm going to steal this shot or look at the composition and copy it. And if you show someone that, they're like, wow, that's a good photo. And I'm like, yeah, but you really didn't create compositionally it. You really just kind of copied it and you knew the lighting. Where if you're, let's say, an artistic minded individual and you pull in and they say, hey, we got this photograph. We want you to make something similar to this. They're going to be lost. I don't know how to do that. You know, I just take pictures of things that look really cool. It's kind of like a lazy way of photography, because you're just like, oh, that's nice. You take a shot. Oh, that's cool. I'll line up, take a shot. But as far as adding in fill flash or a reflector card or changing the light dynamics and the motion of the light, you don't really understand that. So as long as you know those tools, if you're an artistic person, it's going to make you grow a lot faster. And you'll see this time and time again. The third thing is, with seasoned photographers, guys with 20, 30, 40 years, I still see this part. It raises its head up. And photography is no end game. There's no end result. If you could learn it in 5 years and be done, it wouldn't be an art. It'd be very stale. The thing is a lot of individuals get to that. It's almost like a black belt. You know, there's an American Photography Association where you get so many photos over or something, or it's APA or something along those lines, and you become like a grandmaster. It's almost like the black belt in martial arts where some guy gets his black belt and then he stops trying. He stops working out hard, oh, achieved it, I'm there. But the issue with someone with 30, 40 years, seeing this time and time again, I get a book pushed on me. And you're like, okay, I'll check it out. And 1999, you look through it, okay. 2005, oh, you went digital. Wow, okay, kind of cool. Natural light, all right. 2010, huh, kind of the same. 2015, oh, really the same. And then 2020. Like, you hand them the book and you're trying to, and the guy's got 30 or 40 years and, you know, photography's emotion and light, but the most emotion I have once I close that last page is sadness. It's almost like for the last 20 years, they've done nothing new. And no one's gonna tell them that. This is the self-evaluation part that's really important. Someone like myself, or someone 5, 10 years, is not gonna tell a 40-year guy with all these credentials that has worked stale, old, dated, and boring. It's just not gonna happen. The guy was gonna puff up, well, I've been doing this for so long, this, that, and the other thing, or he'll never talk to you again. And you wish you could help him out. Some of them know it, because you'll have guys that come in and they show some work. Maybe they've been shooting for 5 years and it's good. It's real good. And they don't give them a kind of, it's not that good. But really they're kind of envious because this guy used to kind of not suck. And you know, now he's decent and good. And their photography has stayed the same for 20 years. They're in that creative hell. Now some of this issue is simply because they're too lazy. They know the game. They know they have to try something, but they've fallen into that trick that they've arrived and they're established. The other issue, which is a little sadder, is the fact that the artistic-minded person knows some that have done portraits for a living, wedding photography and that, and they still don't realize that they're that person. They're that, you know, artistic vision person, and they need to keep pushing in those uncomfortable areas. They've kind of like, nah, it's my heart. I'm just happy. But they're not happy because they look at their work and it's exactly the same. So I hope this helps. You know, first thing, that everyone progresses the same. Second thing, know who you are. You know, are you a steady relator? Do you like the same things day in or day out? Just know your personality type. If you like coffee at the same time every day, same food, generally you're not going to like change. And photography has changed, you know. You can't step in the same river twice. It's always evolving. That's the same thing as photography. It's always changing. So if you know this, and lastly, there's no established goal for photography. You just have to change with the times and kind of keep updating, keep it fresh. That's what makes it fun. Hope this helped, guys. Comments, questions, concerns, and I will see you next week.